Insulin resistance is extremely common, but also largely undiagnosed. And this is because most doctors are not running the right tests to catch it. Some of the signs of insulin resistance include carrying weight in your midsection, skin tags around your neck, armpits, and groin, and high blood pressure. And here's why insulin resistance often gets missed. It can start up to 10 years before your fasting blood sugar starts to rise, which is the metric that most doctors use to measure it. But by this point, you've already had it for years. You're going to skip the insulin resistance diagnosis entirely and go straight to being diagnosed with prediabetes. But what if you could catch it sooner and get a head start on reversing it? Well, guess what? You can. And in today's video, I'm going to be telling you three of the best ways to test for it. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Kate. I'm a certified health and nutrition coach. I post new videos twice a week here on YouTube talking all things insulin resistance, weight loss, sleep, and more. So if you're ready to take control of your metabolic health, make sure to click that subscribe button. And you can also find me on TikTok and Instagram where I share new posts every single day. Now, if you aren't really sure what causes insulin resistance, I'm not going to go too much into that today. I have several other videos on my channel. I will link one of them up above, which you can check out if you want to know more. But basically, it's when the cells in your body are not responding to insulin correctly. They're not taking in glucose or sugar from the bloodstream as they should. So more insulin has to be produced in order to keep your blood sugar at baseline. And while your blood sugar might look normal in this scenario, your insulin is elevated. And it is these high insulin levels that lead to the associated side effects. So how can you test for insulin resistance? The gold standard test is the homeostatic model assessment for insulin resistance, which can be shortened to HOMA-IR. This test measures your fasting insulin and your fasting glucose and the difference between the two. Basically, this test tells you how much insulin is needed to keep your blood sugar where it is. Your blood sugar might look normal, but if your insulin is elevated, this means it is taking a lot of insulin to keep your blood sugar where it's at, which signifies insulin resistance. And this is why this test can catch insulin resistance years before it progresses to prediabetes, which it ultimately will if you leave it unaddressed. Because there comes a point where more and more insulin is being produced and it simply can't keep up. A HOMA-IR score less than 1 is optimal and shows that you are insulin sensitive. Anything over 1.9 signifies early insulin resistance, and anything over 2.9 signifies you are very insulin resistant. Now, you can ask your doctor to run a HOMA-IR test, and they might be willing to if they're up to date on the current literature. However, a lot of doctors think that looking at fasting glucose alone is enough. They don't understand the significance of testing fasting insulin. But as we already discussed, you can catch insulin resistance years earlier if you look at insulin. So there is one company in the United States who has an at-home insulin resistance test kit. I highly recommend that if your doctor won't run a HOMA-IR test. Sowell Health is currently the only company on the market who is offering an at-home test. And besides testing insulin, blood sugar, and HOMA-IR, this kit also tests other key biomarkers of metabolic health, so you can really get a full picture of where you're at. All it takes is a couple of finger pricks to take the sample, you mail it back, and within a few days, your results are going to be physician reviewed and you're going to receive a full report. And this report is also going to outline the next steps you can take. I'm going to put the link in the description box down below if you want to check out this at-home testing kit. And I also have a promo code for 10% off, so you can use that as well. That is Kate10. The second way you can test for insulin resistance that you can do right now is to measure your waist to height ratio. This is because insulin resistance causes you to store fat around your midsection. So by taking your waist measurement and comparing it to your height measurement, you can get a good sense of if you are insulin resistant or not. All you have to do is divide your waist by your height. A ratio below 0.5 is what you want. That indicates good insulin sensitivity. Anything above 0.5 signifies that you're insulin resistant. And obviously, the higher the ratio, the worse your insulin resistance is. And the final way you can test for insulin resistance is if you have a recent cholesterol panel. You can use this to find your triglyceride to HDL ratio. You find this by dividing your triglycerides by your HDL. Now make sure that your cholesterol numbers are in milligrams per deciliter or else the calculation isn't gonna work out. If your blood panel is in millimoles per liter, then you're gonna take your triglyceride number and times it by 89, and you're gonna take your HDL and times it by 39, and then calculate the ratio. I'm gonna put a calculator in the description box down below if you're a little bit confused. You can just input your numbers there and it'll find it for you. A ratio under 1.9 is considered optimal. This indicates good insulin sensitivity. Between 2 to 3 indicates some level of insulin resistance, and anything over 3 signifies significant insulin resistance. And this ratio has been shown to be a really strong indicator for insulin resistance, but also for your heart disease risk. And this is completely independent of how high or low your LDL is. So don't look at your LDL at all, it's irrelevant. I do have a video I did a couple of weeks ago on why looking at LDL alone is not a good indicator of your health or of your heart disease risk. I'll link that up above and you can check that out afterwards if you want to know more. Now I do want to say that there's one catch to this last formula. If you have already started making the changes that I recommend on my channel on how to reverse insulin resistance and improve your insulin sensitivity, your numbers are going to improve very quickly. Your triglycerides drop and your HDL increases. And that's the catch here. If you've already started making these changes, then your ratio might indicate that you're insulin sensitive when you're really still insulin resistant. If you have an older test, I would suggest looking at that and seeing how your numbers have improved. And if they have improved, that's a good indicator that you're headed in the right direction. But like I said, HOMA-IR really is the gold standard. So ask your doctor to run it, and if they won't run it and you're in the United States, then I highly recommend checking out So Well Health. Again, I'm gonna put that link in the description box down below. And if you've recently been diagnosed with insulin resistance and you're a little bit unsure of where to get started, I do have a 7-day insulin resistance masterclass that gives you everything you need to kickstart your journey and kick insulin resistance in the butt. I've condensed everything you need to know into this program and made it really easy to understand and to implement. It includes a shopping list, a sample meal plan, and you also get access to a private Facebook group where you can ask questions and I can offer you support. I'll put the link to that in the description box down below as well. But anyways, guys, that's all I have for you today. I want to hear from you. Let me know in the comment section if you've been diagnosed with insulin resistance and what test was used to diagnose you. Let me know down below. If you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on how you can improve your insulin sensitivity. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my coaching programs, including my 7-day insulin resistance masterclass, which I mentioned earlier, you can find that here. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.